Good afternoon, students. So far we have discussed about the number systems, surds and logarithms. So I think we have had enough basic classes. So let us continue with the first UC syllabus. So in first UC mathematics, so I am going to start with the chapter 3, trigonometric functions. So this is the chapter 3. Trigonometric functions, and this chapter is there for 19 marks for the annual exam. So this is there for 19 marks for your first UC annual examinations. So in your 10th standard you might have studied about trigonometry. So the word trigonometry is a Greek word. So the trigonometry is nothing but trigonometron. So this now word trigonometry is derived from Greek word trigonometron. So tri means three, it is three. Gon means sides, gon means sides, and then metron means measurement, metron means measurement, metron means measurement. Or this can also be written as trigon and metron. The word trigonometry is derived from the Greek words trigon and metron. So what is the exact meaning of a trigonometry now? It is the study of the relationship between the angles and sides of a triangle. So here I will write the definition. It is the study of, it is the study of the relationship between, of the relationship between, the relationship between, between sides and angles of a triangle, between sides and angles, sides and angles of a triangle, angles of a triangle. So this is the definition of trigonometry. It is the study of the relationship between sides and angles of a triangle. So now next we are going to discuss about angles. The first concept in trigonometric functions is angles, and then we study units of the angles. Or how do you measure an angle? We measure the angle through degree and radian. That we are going to take up now. So meanwhile, pause the video to note it down. Well, now we are going to discuss about angles. So I take two cases here. One is a positive angle and another one is a negative angle. So through these figures we will define the angle. So let us go for the cases. I take the railway. It is O, and this is A. Then, now let us assume that this ray rotates in an anti-clockwise direction. So this is the point B. So here OA is the initial side, and after rotation this OA has reached this position, that is OB. The final position of the ray is called the terminal side. This is initial side. Initial side, and this is the terminal side. This is the terminal side, and the point O is the vertex. This is the vertex. This is the vertex. In this case, we say that so the original side or the original ray is going to have the positive angle. So here it forms an angle. So this case is positive angle. Positive angle. So let us take the second case. So this is the initial side OA and it rotates in a clockwise direction. This is OB. This is OB. And this is the initial side. This is the initial side. Whereas this is the terminal side. Terminal side. So again this point is the vertex and here it is going to have an angle. So in this case it is going to have a negative angle. Second case, negative angle. Negative angle. So now let us give a proper definition of the angle. So I have considered this initial side and it is rotating about its initial point and it is reaching this final position. So this ray has reached this position and this is called the angle. So let us give the definition of the angle now. An angle is a measure of angle definition. An angle is a measure of measure of rotation of a ray rotation of a ray about its initial point. About its initial point. About its initial point. So this is the exact definition of an angle. And then we'll write this initial side and the terminal side. So here the next point it is the original ray. The original ray is called, the original ray is called the initial side, is called the initial side. The original ray is called the initial side. And what about the terminal side? The final position of the ray after rotation is called the terminal side. And final position of the ray. And final position of the ray. Of the ray after rotation is called terminal side of the angle. Is called the terminal side called the terminal side of an angle, of of an angle. So next we'll define the vertex and we'll write the condition for positive angle and the negative angle. So pause the video to note it down. Well, let us give the definition of the vertex. So see here, I have considered this case. This is A, this is B, this is O. Here it forms the angle. This is the initial side and this is the terminal side. And this point is the vertex. So at this point, the rotation is happening. The point of rotation is called the vertex. So the ray, earlier it was like this. And it is rotating in an anticlockwise direction. So at this point, the rotation is happening. That is why the point O is called the vertex. The point of rotation the point of rotation is called the vertex. Is called the vertex. So the next point. So see here, this is the initial side, this is the terminal side, and this is the point O. If the rotation is anticlockwise, then it is said to have a positive angle. In case this is the initial side and this ray rotates in a clockwise direction. So here the ray is rotating in a clockwise direction. In this case it is said to have a negative angle. So let us write these two points now. If the rotation is anti-clockwise, gadiyarada virudha dikkinalli the rotation is anti-clockwise, then it is said to have, then it is said to have, then it is said to have a positive angle. Now, if the rotation is clockwise, if the rotation is clockwise, so next we come across another terminology, that is one revolution. So let us discuss about one revolution. One complete revolution. One complete revolution. So see here, optical ray OA. So this is A, this is OA. So now this ray, one complete revolution means if you start from this point, you have to come back to the same point. That means it is a 360 degree rotation. So that is nothing but one revolution. See here, we have started at this point and again coming back to the same point. So this is the one complete revolution. A, and here I write B. So the initial side and the terminal side are overlapping. So this is the initial side. This is the initial side. This is the terminal side. So what is one revolution now? So the amount of rotation performed to get the terminal side from the initial side. The amount of rotation performed to get the terminal side from the initial side. In that case, we say that the angle is one complete revolution. So this is comfortable in larger angles. For example, a randomly spinning wheel makes 15 revolutions per second. That means for 1 second, it is rotating 15 times. So in such larger angles, we use one complete revolution. Or else, we are going to make use of another two units, that is degree measure and radian measure. So let us write the definition of this complete revolution. The amount of rotation The amount of rotation performed to get terminal side from the initial side. Performed to get the terminal side, to get the terminal side from the initial side, from the initial, from the initial side. So this is all about the today's class. In tomorrow's class, we are going to discuss about degree measure and the radian measure.